Today we're going to look at two-way and intermediate switching using the method called wired through the switch. Previously on the channel we've explored the three-plate and two-plate method for two-way and intermediate switching. So why today wired through the switch for the same two-way and intermediate switching? The reason being it can come up at AM2, AM2S and AM2E, this method. I've already on the channel done a wiring diagram to help you, and I recommend that you do the wiring diagram first, so check out that video. In the description you can download the handout and draw out this two-way and intermediate using wired through the switch. Let's look at the rig I've got in front of me here, because it's subtly different than what we've seen previously. We've still got a supply, in this case coming from a consumer unit, with our line, our neutral and our CPC into the first switch, which will be two-way, a three-core across and a three-core across, making the center one intermediate, the end one a two-way, so we've got two-way and intermediate switching. But you will have noticed that the cable coming out to feed the light is off the last switch. Therefore, feed through the switch will require the neutral from here to make its way all the way to the end so it can actually get up to the lighting point. That's where the wiring diagram video will come in really handy. We're going to bring the camera in a little bit closer and we're going to systematically connect the two-way, intermediate and two-way switches and look at identifying the conductors and where they should go within the switches. So let's look at the first switch, which is going to be two-way, where the feed comes in. So this cable brings in my line, my neutral and my CPC into this two-way switch. So it's this cable here. So these are my conductors. I've already connected the CPCs. So neutral and my permanent line connection come into here. And I've got to then work out my three-core cable, what conductors are going to do what. So one of these is going to have to carry the neutral to the next switch. So we've got a choice, okay? We're probably going to be choosing between black and grey. Now, when the new cable system came in 2004, the black conductor actually became a line conductor, and in the old system pre-2004, the black conductor was a neutral. So the rule was we tried to deneutralize black. So you might be thinking, I'll use the black as the neutral because that's the old system. Actually, the reverse happens. Best practice is not to use the black. However, I'm sure if you do use the black, you'll be commenting below for me. So I'm not going to use the black as my neutral. I'm going to use my grey as my neutral that's going to carry it forward. So that becomes my neutral. This becomes a switching line and this becomes a switching line as well. And we've got a permanent line here. So let's just pause. Let's think about it. We're going to be using the grey for me. The wiring diagram I've previously done also used the grey. So let's get rid of those connections first. Let's fold these out the way. Let's bring my Wago 221 in and simply connect those together. However, remember, you've got to identify your conductors. So this is not identified at the minute as a neutral, so will require oversleeving. So we'll pop the oversleeving on. So that now becomes identified as our neutral. We bring in our Wago connector and we can join those together. So that's that. That's our neutral at this point done. So this is our permanent line coming in and these are our two strappers going out. So it's very much like the conduit method now. Permanent line will come into common, and it doesn't matter which one of the brown and blacks go in L1 and L2, it doesn't matter which way around they go. So neutral's connected, the permanent line goes into common, and the three core two conductors, which will be our strappers, go in L1 and L2. Let's do that next. So pop my permanent line into common, and then my three core is here. I've got to identify now this black conductor is a switching line, so my brown sleeving needs to go over that one. And it's important that you identify your conductors at your AM2S and in industry. So we pop that one in either L1 or L2, I'm not bothered which one it goes in. And my brown conductor in. So that's my two-way of this system done, wired through the switch. Permanent line coming in into common. My three-core I chose black and brown. So black and brown as my strapper conductors. I chose my grey to feed the neutral through to the next switch. And that's it connected. Exactly the same as we did in the wiring diagram. Next one, let's look at the intermediate. CPCs again are already connected. We're used to an intermediate switch with two terminals at the top and two at the bottom. It doesn't matter which way around we go as long as a pair from, say, this left-hand side go in either the top two or the bottom two. And a pair from this side going either the bottom two or the top two. Let's first of all get rid of our neutrals. So the grey coming through here now is a neutral and needs to be identified so. by introducing blue sleeving onto it. And the grey going out will also be a neutral connection. So that will be our neutral going out. And I'll bring in my Wago 221 connector. And I'm going to connect those into there. So that brings my neutral through this one. So I've got my neutral coming through here. And now I've got a set either side. So both sides have got a set. Again, identify the black as a switching line conductor or part of our strapper system. And then we're going to also double these ends over. They weren't doubled over. So just strip those back. I always like doubled over terminations. So pop those in. So this will be our intermediate switch. So we've got the brown and black from the left hand side. Let's connect that first. Again, it doesn't matter whether it goes in the top two or the bottom two, but we don't want to go across the sides. So it's got to be either the top two or the bottom two. So drop those in there. You heard me kick my screwdriver on the floor, pick that back up. Connect those up into my intermediate switch. We always like them to match, but it doesn't matter. So we always like them to go brown to brown, black to black. Doesn't really matter, but let's put them in. So neat, push that down. That's my intermediate switch connected. So let's have a look there. We've got a pair, in this case from the left-hand side in the top two, and a pair going off to our two-way switch, again at the bottom there. And we've identified the gray conductor as our neutral. So let's go to the last one, which again is our two-way switch, but we've now got a different cable in here because we've got the one going up. We know that's going to be the neutral. We know our grey's brought our neutral through. So we move those about, and I'll bring in some blue sleeving so I can identify my neutral. Remembering it's this grey one here, which is going to be identified as our neutral connection. And we're going to put it again in a Wago 221 connector. I know I've shown on the video before switches from Schneider that actually have a neutral connection. Somebody said they also do them with Hager. So there's our neutral, which now makes its way up here in order to get up to the light. Fold that one out of the way. We've got our strappers coming in. So let's pop brown sleeving onto our black one to identify as a switching line conductor. And this one will go up to our light point. That'll be our switch one. So that one there is important we get it in the right place. That's got to go into common. That goes into common of our switch. And then it doesn't matter which way around the other two conductors go for L1 and L2. So pop that one into there. And again, these go in L1 and L2. It doesn't matter which way around they go. But we've identified all our conductors. And that's our two-way switch. Finished off in there, a little bit of copper shown on the bottom. I'm sure somebody will mention that. Okay, so that's our two-way switch, and there's our neutral going up. So we've got our switch line, our neutral, and our CPC making its way up to the light point. So that is it. That's how to connect the switches when we're looking at the wiring system wired through the switch. So we've brought the neutral all the way to this end point so we can get it up to the light end point. Let's have a look at our connections now, our baton lamp holder. It could be ceiling rose and pendant, it could be down lights. So we've got our neutral connection against the side of our lamp. We've got our switching line connection against the side of our lamp, and as it's a fully insulated fit, and we've got our CPC connected in the back here. So we're all now connected up with this different wiring system for two-way and intermediate. So there we have it, wired through the switch. Let's just do a small recap. So our permanent line, neutral, and CPC came into the first switch. That permanent line goes into common, and this is what we usually do when we're wiring in PVC singles using the conduit looping method. Because at the last two-way switch out of common, we had our brown switching line conductor that went up to the light point. And then between the two-way switch and intermediate, we brought those other two conductors, the strappers, through there. We also brought the neutral through. So our neutral that came down to here connected to a grey conductor identified with blue sleeving that found its way all the way to the last point so it could take the neutral up to the light. So therefore, we've done the system wired through the switch that could well be used at AM2, AM2S and AM2E. But always remember, there is a chance they can change their assessment. So make sure when you go into your assessment, you're comfortable with all the wiring systems so you can do the best you can on that day. Also, another top tip, make sure you go on the pre-preparation day. So go there a week or so before and get some preparation done, because you might find there's one or two bits you might struggle with. So hopefully this video has linked to that wiring diagram and given you a little bit more insight about this method wired through the switch, in order to have two-way and intermediate switching that could be in your AM2. But as always, I hope this video has been some help.